Hey guys, Tales of Turam here. We're back with the Pathfinder game with Big Shot, Zeus, Pedrick, and joining us again after missing a few sessions, the Leshy character. Can't even remember the fucking name. But anyways, today will be the last session probably of this Pathfinder game for them, just because I was planning on ending theirs anyway soon, and I had a good idea, and somebody else wanted to join a D&D game. So we'll be ending it here. This session might be a little bit longer than usual, I don't know. And we'll try to get a few things done with the characters. Anyways, we have 20 seconds left to go. Boop, bop, beep, boop, 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 bop. 8 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, I almost hit stop recording like an idiot. anyways, I'll unmute you guys.
Oh. I was tuning my fucking soundboard while I was waiting.
Let me get to the intro now, please.
Unmute Big Shot, he's still fucking muted.
No, he's playing Guitar Hero.
He muted himself.
No, he didn't.
Well,
when... See? Fuck you. Anyways. let me get some music started here, you know? Boop bop, beep 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 boop bop, bop 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 bop, you know?
One. Bars.
I think it's this one. Yeah, I'm gonna play this one.
Bars.
I hope this is not copyright. I don't give a shit if it is.
You don't make money off of this yet. It's fine.
I don't.
Liberty to slum.
So, we find ourselves once again. I'm gonna mute you, Johnny, just because. We find ourselves once again in the continent of Tyrellian, home of the elves, a large forest-based continent with rolling. Large bluffs, hills to the western reaches, the dark forest to the eastern. We find ourselves in this land of social intrigue towards an eastern middle part of the continent. The floating city of Tirok, capital of this great empire of Tyrellian, as well as seat to the throne, as well as the royal court. Now, where last we left off, we had found ourselves watching as Pedrick and Zeus went on interesting nights of their own, as Klara had finished up her, what is it called, trials to enter into the servitude of the Church of Celis. Klara had been told the festival will hold her initiation as well as many of the others. Pedrick woke up after a drunken night bender in the room of one of the princesses of Tyrellian, and with a few other women. Zeus had spoken and done other things with his current companion, we don't know, Lillian. All of which missed the, hey, come here and, except for, actually no, Klara would have gone back, yeah, so Klara was the only one who, made it to the ThunderBranch family home on time the night before. Actually, no, because she missed that too. No, none of those three, I apologize. Made it to the family home. They all missed the escort and got there on their own. Meanwhile, we're gonna turn back the clock a little bit to the day before, around noon, when the rest of the party went to do their own separate things. Pangolin.
Yes.
What did you do?
Remind me again the situation. It's been a minute.
You and your group have just arrived at the capital after committing identity fraud to get in.
I committed it fraud?
No, the party did with you there.
We all committed.
So it's kind of just accessory fucking crime. All right.
Yes. After saying you're the ragtags, which are a group of performers from Giraffe, you decided to say, yeah, we're them, and I hate you so much, Zeus. Well, that technically was an alien the other day, but yes. the group that you are apparently supposed to be is performing tonight for the ThunderBranch family, and then the next night for the ball. Which is going to happen the day before the festival, and then continue on to the festival.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
You have arrived with, the carriage is moving. You see Klara jump off, start to talk with Pedrick and Osha. Well, Osha's asleep, sorry. Pedrick about meeting back up at the Mage's Respite where they exist at the moment, where you guys are going to at the moment, later tonight to be escorted to the ThunderBranch family home. Would you like to hop off or continue to the Mage's Respite?
Sure, let's hop off.
Okay, so, as you hop off into the overcast weather of this large city, you hit upon the... Can you guys stop? I'm trying to fucking explain what's going on here, and it's fucking Markiplier eating glue to distract me. Thank you. Jesus.
Yummy.
Anyway, so. I'm just gonna close Discord for a second. Yes.
Good choice, Princess.
Go. Anyway, so.
Zeus, what does this mean?
Yes.
It's from the future. You don't know about it. Sorry, continue.
Good choice, Princess.
I'm sad.
So, as you hop off of the carts, the beautiful swan-like carriage of white colors, pearlescent, beautifully drawn by these wonderful horse-based creatures.
Fair enough.
As the sun-baked sky, which you're usually used to, it would give you a boost of adrenaline to an extent because you're a plant. Mostly cloudy and becoming more and more overcast as the day progresses. You jump onto the large stone tiles upon the ground, and you look around. You see the cart begin to head towards this large mage's tower that stands out around the entire city. You see this large city made of multiple islands that connect through tree trunks from the large center tree in the very center of it, as well as just bridges that climb over large waterways that pour off the side of the island. You see, the island itself is nestled within a large space in the clouds themselves as this large tree pushes past the clouds above. You see the tree itself. Many branches come off of it, the leaves, whatnot. You see, upon it, there's this large stone spiral that goes all the way up, and you can see many different buildings upon it. You see the large city expands outwards. You see a floating area with multiple pillars that seem to float around on rings. You see many different buildings. The area you're in does not have a lot of buildings, like, right by it. It is a main entryway to the city, which you see a few people coming in. You see what seems to be, in the distance, a small, not bazaar, but... What's the other name for a bazaar? Market, there it is.
Flea market?
Market, yes. You see a market of different things people are selling. It's starting to get within noon of the day, so it's getting a little bit more busy. You hear the sounds of, hey, fresh flying seal, blah, 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 and people talking. You see multiple individuals coming through the gates. There's a large portion of this city that is coming to for an unknown reason. The city is probably miles in width. As you're looking, you can see it rolls up and down in different areas. The large buildings, you see multiple spired towers for wizards, as well as multiple other strange houses and oddities. You see floating small islands that have their own towers or houses on them, chained to the outskirts of the city or floating above the city itself. You see carriages drawn by Pegasi being flown through the city by either noblemen or rich individuals or even guard people. You see floating bubbles where individuals are sitting in them, and you see people just flying through the city in different means as well. You see carriages passing through the city. What are you doing?
Is there a library inside?
Make me a perception check.
Alright. Let's see. Skills? What the fuck is I'm trying to find perception. Or two, what reflects will
offense or defense.
Ah, offense. Plus 11. Okay. Let's see. Fucking rolls. R1D20 plus 11. 30.
30?
Yep.
Okay. So, as you're looking around at the city from your small vantage point, you see what looks like a few people that are flying in these strange school-like attires, these robes, start to fly towards that large pillar that has multiple floating towers and rings around it. They seem to land, pulling out books themselves and starting to talk with others going towards it.
I'm gonna go there.
Okay, so. No, I'm eating Taco Bell.
I'm eating Pop-Tart.
So, as you begin to walk that way, you start to walk through the city, you start to hear individuals talking with that fucking insane perception roll. did you hear about the pillar last night? You mean the calling of Celis? Yes. Strange. I heard it was a mage who caused it. No. It could not be anybody but Celis herself. Then you hear, what about the explosion from before? Oh yes, that was... Do you think those two are connected? They might be. As you guys continue to walk, you hear, I heard the princess was returned last night by a valiant student of the academy. I did too. What was their name again? Honestly, it's such a stupid name, I can't remember it.
Alright.
As you continue, you start to make your way towards this large area. And you see the ground on this island that's connected to this large pillar seems to drop down hundreds of feet at least. And you see, connecting to the outside ring, this brass-like ring that floats around the many different towers on the outside portion of it, with a few towers nestled onto the ring itself, a large bridge that seems to move up and down with the wind and the bobbing of the island itself, which is strange because it's made of stone. It looks natural, like, it doesn't look like it's breaking or anything, it looks like it's moving like a wave, but it's made of stone. As you look at it, you see multiple statues and gargoyles on it. Some of the gargoyles come to life and start to fly around as others land in the spot that's now vacant.
How neat.
You see what looks like a few carriages passing by, individuals landing, and you see another individual standing at the edge of the bridge as some people come up, flip him some coins, and he goes, all right, now, and he knocks his staff onto the ground as the entire group starts to float, and he goes, all right, be careful. They're already gone, fucking dumbasses. And he lands again. Wingman services! Small fee of 2 silver per person, please!
Alright.
And he says that as you continue to walk. You see one of the closest towers on one of the rings. There is a very obviously burnt and charred blackened spot on one of the windows of the areas. And all you right. see what looks like individuals on the side floating with these strange discs under them, going up and just like slowly moving their hands as you see this, similar to druidic magic, the stone starts to mold and form once again.
My brain
deformed over the course of its burning.
My brain is imagining those flying bubbles from Home.
Yes. So, as you see this, they seem to be repairing something from damages that have been sustained. What are you doing?
You said that? Where's the trigger for box part? Hold on.
You see individuals that look like students walking in.
I'm gonna follow them.
So as you start to walk upon this grand bridge, it's like 50 feet wide at least. As you begin to follow them, you hear... Did you hear that Tatriel caused another explosion in her room? Again? Isn't this like the fifth one? Yes, but she hasn't been seen since last night. I heard she fell down into the river below. Ah, the Warrens. Isn't she dead then? Yes, they'll probably fish her corpse up tomorrow.
Tatriel. Alright, noted. Tatriel. Alright.
Did you also hear the headmaster has locked himself away? Really? Strange, he never does so. Well, I heard he's practicing something for some zenith coming up. Where'd you hear that? Oh, I actually overheard it while I was sneaking through the library. Oh. Well, don't let anybody know you know that. He may get mad at you. Of course, I know the headmaster. How do you know him? Anyways, how are your studies going? And they continue to walk.
Alright. So either Tantri or the headmaster. Well, is there a reception area, kind of? Like a front desk?
You're still walking over the bridge.
Okay.
You continue?
Yes.
Alright, eventually you do get into this large brass ring, where it actually connects, to one of the towers at this point, before the brass ring you can get into. And you do see what looks like this large, expansive upwards tower with a few staircases that seem to shift and move and change with doorways that lead to unknown areas. As you look at it, people are walking up and down, and the very center of this area is a singular circular desk where you see this elven woman with a bun on her head that seems to be golden in color, much like her hair. A little bit of crow's feet starting to form at her eyes, and these blue...
And that never hurt nobody.
The blue shades of blue eyes. She seems to be in this vest, this blue vest that doesn't... blue arm sleeveless vest...
Blazer, you mean?
I don't know what the fuck a blazer is.
It's basically just a formal vest.
Blazer. Yeah, except it doesn't have fucking sleeves, is what I'm saying.
Okay.
It's basically a blazer without sleeves, and it's very pulled tight and actually buttoned together. It has golden buttons and white trim to it, and she has a white shirt underneath it as she's starting to... talk to individuals coming up to her. You see she's a little bit busy as she cracks a small vial and another version of her shifts out but muted more to grayish in color. And they can
Odd, but I've seen worse.
There are multiple people in this room, like maybe close to 50, 60 people.
Alright.
Around talking.
I'm going to... trying to approach the lady.
Okay, give me a second. I'm gonna eat my burrito started now.
Yeah, it's alright.
Fucking delicious.
I physically cannot be horny as a leshy. I do not have that part.
Oh,
I cannot.
To.
Well, and I can, and I'm gonna end well.
Have you ever seen The Raven in Starfire? You know what I'm talking about?
I mean, I do still have hands and a very adept tail.
Anyway. So, as you approach, do you wait in line or do you try to push through?
I'm gonna patiently wait in line.
Right.
No one ever got far by rushing through too fast.
About 2 hours pass and eventually you get up
to the Jesus. Jesus Christ.
Some more information you got is something about an explosion last night and some sort of fucking... tower, well, pillar of God or something.
That's not worrying at all. I love when a pillar of God explodes. That's amazing.
You eventually get to the help desk and the woman goes, it seems that's all. And she starts to go back to her work because you're smaller than the desk.
Miss, excuse me?
Who said that?
Down here.
Oh, hello.
Hi,
I was... I'm sorry. Is there any... I'm sorry, my mind's everywhere.
Stop stuttering, please. And get to it.
I was wondering if there's any books anywhere that I could check out. I'm not a student, or... I'm not, but... Is it available I could just read them, or... kind of library, if this is what I think it is?
I apologize, this is not a public library. This is a school for mages. If you are... If you are coming into here, you... you're allowed to come in. However, we're not allowing individuals other than the mages of the academy to check out or rent books.
How does one become a mage of the academy?
We're not currently... It'll be a few months before we start up our bringing of new students in, of course.
Okay.
But you would have to pass a test. Or you would have to be... Sorry, this burrito's hot as shit. Give me a second. Or you would have to be... I'm trying to think of the word. It's like when somebody... recommended by somebody else.
Shut the fuck up, Bill. One more time.
You had to pass a test or be recommended by somebody else.
Okay.
I'm just server muted him.
So... How hard is this said test?
Well, we're not doing the tests just yet, as I just said.
Well, I mean, whenever it does happen, is it difficult, or
just
is it...
Test your magical abilities and see if you're worth entering into the college.
Okay, is there any way I...
Of course fucking Viber stops when I'm doing my fucking session.
Is there any way I could be notified of openings at some point? Is that an option?
As I said, it'll be in a few months.
Yes, I know. I mean, whenever it does happen, if I could be notified.
Jesus fucking Christ, bro. You just aren't understanding what I'm saying.
I understand what you're saying.
Write down your name here. She hands you a paper.
Okay. Just, alright. And I understand what you're saying, Goblin. I'm saying,
your character isn't gonna fucking matter in after this session.
True.
Yeah.
Let's see. Alright, I wrote down my name. Okay, well...
We'll notify you when time comes.
Do you know if there's any other public libraries around here? I'm new in the city.
It's a natural one? No, I don't.
Helpful. Alright, well, nice talking to you. Those burritos fucking amazing. He's fucking scruffling around. Oh, that was useless.
I got dipped it in some nacho cheese sauce and all the meat fell out of it.
Ah. Oh, that was useless. Well, what now? I'm gonna go and I'm gonna just go try and look for a garden to go fucking tend to for the moment.
Sure,
the pastime.
Make me a perception check or a nature check, your choice.
No, what am I better at? Hold on. Nature is plus 9. Perception.
Plus 11.
Yeah. rolls. Did you dare to tread in my house? Wrong rolls. Alright, rolls. 1d20 plus 11. 22.
Sorry, it's really spicy.
Dog, take a fucking breather.
No. What'd you roll?
22.
Alright. You see from this distance, what looks like a garden up in that tree district, or what it is. At the very top of it. Or you see a few gardens that look nice, but you see a very nice one at the very top of it.
To the tree district! To the top!
Okay, so. As you get to the bridge that leads over to the tree, you're stopped by some guards who look at you and go, what business do you have here?
I apologize. I didn't want to take off guards. My business here is, well, I've been going around past few years and helping out guards, sending to them, revitalizing them, giving them boosts to whatnot. Magical, normal, all sorts.
Interesting. This is the Noble District.
The Noble District.
Do you have any reason to be here other than tending to gardens?
Well, I am part... Fuck, what was the name of the fucking thing again? I am part of the group that is going to be performing for some of the notable... Some of the... God, what the fuck's their name again? The fucking one family. The fuck's their name again?
I don't know.
The fucking... Fuck. Intelligence. Fucking... fucking intelligence is plus one. Yikes. Rolls 1d20 plus 1, 17.
It's the ThunderBranch family, and the group is called the Ragtags.
Oh, I'm part of the Ragtags, performing for the ThunderBranch family.
Gerald, do you know about these? And Gerald pulls out a scroll. Let me see. Oh, yes, right here. The Ragtags. They were going to escort you later today, but I guess coming in early isn't too bad. Apologies for the inconvenience, little one.
Oh, no, it's all right.
The ThunderBranch family is, and he starts to give you directions. They're about halfway up the tree.
All right, cool. All right, thank you, sirs. I'll be on my way.
Of course.
Stay safe.
You too. Also, be careful. There was an attack last night in the district, so you might want to stay out of any alleys you find.
Okay, thank you. Stay safe, guards.
As they let you go by, you walk over the small bridge and begin to walk up. As you see Klara walking with a few priests of a temple off in the distance before she disappears into a bit of a crowd.
Huh? Okay.
So, what are you doing?
I am heading to the top of the tree.
Top of the tree, okay.
To the garden.
You eventually get up to the top of the tree and you see this small area that seems to flatten out. There's less buildings here, and it's still curved upwards a bit, but you see a large staircase that heads up to a small plateau that's been built here of stone and wood. You see to the left side, there's another staircase that leads up, and outside of it, you see these small waterfalls these small hedges that fall down it with the staircase, as well as small waterfalls that pour out of the tree. You're not sure how or where from, and they come to these small basins at the very base of the stairs. There's many guards around it, and then to the right of this area, like completely right, you see the area is covered with grass and stone and wood, but to the right you see this large garden of statues, fountains, flowers, bushes, trees, different things.
Mind
you, there are trees and stuff like this in the city. It's just not as prevalent as here. And you see things that aren't in the city or from around this area.
All right. Time to do the magic of tending to the gardens. I want to note any unusual plants.
Right, roll me a nature check.
My nature is plus 9. I'm still on the rolls channel. 20 plus 9.
If you want to play another
Nat 20 plus 9.
If you want to play another Leshy in the next upcoming campaign in D&D, we can make a Leshy race. But anyways,
29, Nat 20.
29, Nat 20. You see a few that aren't natural to Tyrellian from what you've been told by the people you lived with. You see the Dorothian sand tree, which is a almost petrified-looking tree of gray bark that seems to sprout out in different directions and has these small leafless branches almost hanging like a willow tree. But on the edges of it, as you walk up, you could see small bits of dew pop out of the offshoots of the branches. You also see things like Atarla's blade, which is a grass type that is very deep green with small bits of purple, and it has... It's used very... Mostly in Darath in the Eastern world, but it is said to have medicinal properties.
Well, I'm going to definitely pull out my little notebook and take notes of that.
You also find a strange bush made of just blackened grass called death grass. It's usually made when someone dies or undeath or necromancy is present around it.
That's worrying. Hold, please.
No.
Let's see. Yeah. Well.
Can you catch the garden for how long?
Maybe an hour and a half or two.
Okay. 2 hours would be putting you towards sunset-ish, because sunset is at 6. Like, completely gone at 6.
Alright.
So, as you're starting to do this, you do see a few other gardeners come out and are clipping and whatnot and pointing out different things to you because they see you're doing their job, so they're not going to fucking stop you. Eventually, as night is coming, what are you going to do? What are you doing?
I can't think of anything important to do other than... Well, I should probably try and get to the rest of the party so we can perform. I'm going to try and get to the rest of the party to perform for the ThunderBranch people.
So, are you heading to the ThunderBranch family home, or are you heading back to the Mage's Respite?
To the home.
Okay.
I'm here, why not?
Eventually, you get to the ThunderBranch family home. You see this large guarded gate off to the side of the tree. You see this large courtyard that leads into the house, which the front of it is nestled onto the tree itself. You see a few carriages are pulled up into the courtyard, and you are still outside this large iron gate. You see a few guards looking down to you. They're dressed in half plate with these... yellow and green kind of half capes, papulets, I don't know what they're called, upon their left shoulder, that seems to fall down to, like, their wrist, and they are elven in nature, and they go, "Hello, little one, what are you doing here?"
Oh, I'm here to perform for the, family, the ThunderBranch. I'm part of the ragtags.
Well, you're not here to perform tonight, it's tomorrow night, but still. We were told
instructions
to let,
then.
Yes, we were told to let you all in, so feel free. Jeremy, and you see this half elven individual, very obvious half elven. He has a more roundish face. He goes, "Yes, let these people in, please." But it's a fucking plan. Jeremy, it's not what we decide, it's what the master says. All right. The gate opens. This large, majestic courtyard of
a
fountain in the very center, and you can
more
see
more than just a plant.
You see a fountain in the very center. These dirt paths around with gravel inserted into some parts. You see hanging branches actually descend into the courtyard a bit, and these pieces of moss seem to fall down. Vegetation is just everywhere in this courtyard, and it looks like it hasn't been, if you weren't so, knowledgeable about nature, you would be like, this is an unmaintained garden, but you could see everything is delicately placed in certain areas. What the fuck?
You should probably unmute Big Shot, because he's fucking serving it still.
Yeah, I know, because he fucking won't shut the fuck up. So, you see what looks like an unorganized area, but to your natural brain, you're like, oh, this is pretty well organized. Pieces and places that make it look nice, basically. It's very organized.
Alright. I'm going to head for the... Well, just kind of meander forward or vaguely the right direction.
Alright, you meander. You look towards the front of the house and start to walk that way, I guess.
Yep, that seems right.
Okay. Eventually, you're ushered in by a few maids after being invited because of what you say. And you're shown to a room for the night to allow you to rest, recuperate, do what you need to do. Do you rest for the night?
Yep.
Okay. Now I just need to wait for Big Shot to rejoin because he fucking left for no reason.
He couldn't do anything. He was passively waiting.
Yeah. I was trying to get your shit done first. That's why I fucking muted him.
Fair enough.
I guess he just won't be in the ending session then.
Hold on.
I'm giving him 3 minutes before I just continue without him.
Jesus!
I type fast, I'm sorry. It all that was typed perfectly, I do.
Angry.
Fuck, I spelled professor with 4 S's.
Yeah.
Anyways. I'm still waiting for him to join, he has 2 minutes.
Raven Rock.
Who's fucking punching shit?
Me.
Is he joining or no?
He has not responded yet. I'm just kind of warning.
He has 1 minute and probably like 10 seconds left.
There he is.
Let me just unmute him now. Alright, he's unmuted now.
Oh.
Yeah, my grandma called me and grandma comes first.
Yeah. So, as the night progresses, let me see if the music bot's back up or not really quickly here, just because we have another minute.
Yeah, my Gam Gam called me. I love my grandma.
Yeah,
she actually wants to learn D&D.
Oh, boy.
Yeah.
That'd be... Do not ever invite her to a fucking party with...
Oh, that's fucking why. Because they have Viber in their fucking thing, too.
What?
Remove him from that party.
Hold on, let me just go let them know that's what's fucking going on.
And I did shout out that he was
just for your information, we can't use Viber in our voice call if it's in yours too. Just
yeah, I just didn't see you using Viber, so that's why I took it.
It died, that's why. Anyway, I'm gonna go back.
Syphilis.
I'm back now. Let's see Gonorrhea. If Mantaro works now. Mantaro doesn't work.
Fred Boat, I think, works still.
What's Fred Boat? No, I don't think it does.
Worked the other day for me.
Doesn't work for me at all. Hi there. These links aren't supported. YouTube doesn't fucking work anymore.
Uh-huh.
Let's go with this, I guess.
Coco Melon.
No.
I'm never gonna let my kid watch that shit.
Neither am I.
No, Fred Boat just doesn't work. It's fucking retarded.
I don't want to be a helicopter parent, but I am not letting my kid watch shit like that. Fucking brain rot.
And Hydra doesn't fucking move, fucking work either. Does Avarite do fucking things or no? No, it doesn't do fucking things. Rhythm should, but it's not.
You should just get a soundboard to play it.
Say the Adler.
What'd you say? You said say the N-word? Okay.
Say the Adler.
Say the Adler. Oh. Oh.
Okay, let's find a music bot for D&D.
Yeah.
Fred boat doesn't fucking work. Oh, let's see if this one does.
Sounds well. Bing chilling, Von Chue. Bing chilling.
Ming chilling?
What she want? Bing chilling. Sounds well. Bing chilling.
Did I add it to a different server on accident? Uh-oh.
Dumbass.
Gooby. How many servers do you have?
I don't know. I was able to add it to a server, and I don't know which one it was because I didn't add it to any of the servers I'm in or that I host. So how do I use this now?
That's why I issue ready.
I see. That's how I do it. Okay.
Well, I want to see what I'll get on the random character.
Is it
for the 5e characters? Are we still just doing 70?
Damn, that's a lot of sixes.
How the fuck do you use Meeseeks? Oh, it's a slash, Meeseeks. Even though it says it's not. Okay, that's fucking retarded, bro.
Are we still doing 70 for the 5e characters?
75.
75. Okay.
What the fuck? How do you play? It says it can play music, yet it doesn't let me fucking play music on it. This bot sucks ass.
Womp womp. Jesus Christ. The fucking god roll.
What? Look.
Motherfucker got an 85 and then an 81.
I got a 90. Fuck 16, off.
16, 15, 13, 9.
Okay, it says that's the command prefix, but it's not. Oh, wait, we're playing. I don't give a shit anymore. Fuck this shit, bro. Fuck this shit. So, where do we leave off?
I went to sleep.
Okay.
I'm fucking sleeping.
So,
as you are sleeping, fucking music, bro. You know what? I'll just open Spotify on my end. Fuck you guys.
I have yet to get a single fucking 75. There we go. That's a 76. Let's see what the next roll is.
Bad you didn't get a 69 on there.
I know, that's what I'm saying.
You could have taken it and gotten an extra feat.
Honestly, I don't really like feats that much. That's what Domino did. There's only a few ones that I actually like.
You know, that's what Domino did. He got a 69, didn't choose anything else, just took a feat extra. So he's starting with 2 feats.
Well, yeah, most bipedals start with 2 feats.
That was actually a funny one.
I know.
music on my end. So, I wonder if it's picking up. Give me a second. No one talk. It is picking it up. Okay, good. I think so anyways. Let's see. One more time. Yeah, it's on desktop audio. Good. So, sorry about that. So, as you sleep, as the night becomes moist and wet, dreams of the forest once again push into your mind, your unconscious mind. Thinking about the past, what's gone on. You awaken in the morning to the sound of wind pushing against the large window within your room. And you hear in the halls, "Just this way. I will allow you to eat breakfast with us." And you hear another individual going, "All right." A very familiar voice to you. Klara. However, as you go to your door to check outside, they're already gone.
Damn. You gotta tease me like that? Fucking blue baller.
Hey, you blue balled the fucking man, but still.
Hey, hey, hey. You deserve it.
Blue balled him just yet.
Wow.
I like how I went to a brothel in a side session and just belittled the fuck.
That wasn't a side session. That's technically still not.
Oh yeah,
session.
that was a real session, yeah. Mm-hmm. I went to a brothel and just belittled a man.
So,
who had no right getting belittled by me.
As you find yourself I don't know if you wear clothes. Dressed for the day.
I kind of wear clothes.
I would assume your character would go out to the front garden in the courtyard, right? Because it's interesting.
Correct.
Alright, so as you are fixing up the arrangement a little bit, trimming what needs to be trimmed. Oh, I was like, what's that fucking noise that's going eee? It's just my ear. Okay.
Oh, yeah, we go.
As you go out to the garden, an hour passes, and you finish up what you were doing. And eventually you hear, you've heard a few people be introduced in the garden, a few noblemen, whatnot. And you hear, "And finally, arriving, all the way from Durath." Sorry, you hear, "Finally arriving, members of the Ragtag. From Durath, we have both Sir Pedrick, the Gunslinger, and Osha." Is Osha again? The Bounty Hunter! Accompanied by the beautiful proprietor of Sakura's Blessing down in the Flower District. Oh, yes, folks. The Kitsune, known as Mrs. Lillian. At this point, you see one of the carriages open up. And roll me a perception check, please, as both of you, both Klara and the plant, are now outside at this point, because Klara came out at this point as well. Both of you roll me perception checks.
Yes, Marsh.
14, damn.
Okay. Who's playing a PS2?
It's a fucking train, dipshit.
I heard...
Yeah.
The train!
Sorry, it's train?
I got a 17.
Yes!
Hold on, it's a train?
That
awful.
That was terrible.
Awful.
You know my rule.
17 and 14? Okay, so, as soon as the carriage door opens, it folds down like a Lamborghini, creating a staircase. And you're expecting these two wonderfully dressed individuals to step out. Klara, your keen kobold nose starts to shrivel as you smell vileness coming out of the carriage. It smells like a mixture of... Let's see. Yeah, I rolled a secret thing for you. It smells like a mixture of piss, alcohol, vomit. You're not sure what else, but those are the three distinct things you pick up.
Come...
You don't... Well, maybe.
Well, I mean, Clara does, but you don't.
Johnny, you yeah. don't smell anything. You're just looking over there like, ah, it's my friends. And you see wobbling out. If you would like to describe, if both of you would like to describe what you're doing, because remember what you said last session? Describe what's happening, please, Patrick and Zeus. How you are presenting yourselves.
I am very...
What you are wearing, what you, how you look, what how you're presenting yourselves.
I'm wearing the clothing that the driver gave me.
So a nice tuxedo.
Yes. And I'm trying my best.
Oh yeah, I forgot to mention that. The one introducing them is the carriage driver. So you see this Jeeves-looking elf that's very old, just completely in boxer shorts that have hearts on them, as he's introducing them. But continue, sorry.
And just trying to, like, as dragging behind me, because I'm not strong at all. Lillian, it, as quickly into the building as possible to
well,
find a bathroom.
This is you stepping out for a second.
Oh, Patrick, yeah.
Patrick, are you stepping out with them? Patrick? Hello?
Patrick.
Yes. Patrick.
You are very...
Patrick.
I can't hear
he's
you.
Fucking, he's quiet as fuck.
How about now?
There we go.
Okay, so you're stepping out, yes?
Yes.
Please
but,
describe... go ahead.
I was about to say, I don't remember what he was wearing.
So, stepping out, you see a man with skin that
oh.
has folded in on him, because you don't have your mask.
No, I don't, but I remember what I'm wearing now. I'm just wearing a green cloak, so I'm back to the cloak and no clothes.
Kind of look like Margit from fucking Elden Ring at the moment.
Yeah.
Oh, God. So, you see this monstrosity stepping out. Patrick, if you'd like to describe yourself.
So you see a man who's... Well, he's no longer covered in scars, but his body is still covered in burns, and he's missing both arms, and that they have been replaced with prosthetic ones. And his face is basically, like... on one side of the upper half of his face is just kind of caved in. Half of his jaw is missing. And there's just all sorts of disfigurement. And
he's just also, all sorts of fucked up.
There's also green chitin growing out of his face.
Ugh.
And he's
that motherfucker.
This beautiful billowing cloak of just forest green that seems to shimmer in the night, in the early morning.
It's made of silk.
Yes, it's made of silks. And they both seem to be propping up this beautiful kitsune, who seems to be wearing this furling dress that falls from her waist, or it would technically be a skirt, I guess, from her waist down to her ankles, dragging behind her a little bit. This beautiful, as you're looking at it, you would notice, it looks like it's made of a curtain that's been stitched together multiple times.
If we can pull on a weekend at Bernie's.
Yeah, we are. We made that joke last time.
Yes, and as they are stepping out, she seems to also be wearing curtains that are acting like wrappings around her breasts. And she has this set of strange sunglasses on her eyes. As they step out, Bussy Boy, Johnny Shitknuckles, roll me perception checks, please. And Patrick and Zeus, please roll me a performance check.
Oh, I'm great at those. Hold on a second. Performance.
24.
And then for Sylvanas. Oh god, Sylvanas rolled a natural 20. Oh shit.
What's funnier than 24?
26.
Alright, I got 28.
28, okay. So, let's see. Johnny Shitknuckles roll. Johnny, what did you roll?
Perception. Oh, I didn't roll.
Perception. Patrick, what did you roll for yours?
Just a second.
So, you can. Sorry, I apologize. You can roll performance or deception, both of you two, Zeus or Patrick.
Or deception. Oh, okay, yeah. Deception is.
13. Wow, these fucking rolls suck right now.
I rolled performance.
Okay. Oh, natural one for a 13.
So. Cancels those out. Okay, so, as they step out, you see, Lillian seems to, her head lolls for a second over to, the right, which is where Osha is standing, and it goes onto his shoulder. Osha tries to, like, say, "Oh, Lillian, come on, not in front of these people." And then you guys see you guys see this vile liquid pour out of the carriage onto the steps. Patrick suddenly trying to deceive you, slips on it, pulling Lillian down the stairs with him, as all three of them fall down, hitting the ground below. The sunglasses fall off, and you can obviously see a plastered, completely drunk, hungover, unconscious Lillian on the ground.
How lovely.
Is this how your group always is, Madame Klara?
There's a reason they call us ragtag, but we aren't usually this ragtag.
All right, I'll see what our house doctor can do. But anyways, welcome everyone. We should be receiving a few more guests later on, but for now, please join us in the dining hall. Prepare yourselves for tonight. Tomorrow night, I should say. Tonight, you'll be staying here at the Grand ThunderBranch Estates. Please find yourselves at home and be prepared for tomorrow night's ball. My son, Eldrin, will be heading it, so I please ask that if you have any questions, come to him or me. Anyways, thank you for joining us, and we're going to get her taken care of for a second. And he walks away from you, Klara, towards the other two.
Yikes. Big yikes.
That's gonna be a demerit in your pay.
Yeah. We're being paid? Oh.
I didn't know we're being paid.
We're committing identity fraud and stealing their money.
Klara, you're like, fuck, he was talking about payment. Shit. That's going to be demerit to it. Now the negotiations are going to be a bit harder. You're like, wait, shit. I'm not the one negotiating that. Isn't that halfling doing it?
That halfling. Oh my god.
Yeah. Anyways, you guys are eventually pulled inside to your rooms or to common rooms, wherever. If there's any roleplay you would like to do, we can go over it. I'm going to skip the ball. I'm just going to have you roll a performance check, just so you're aware. So if you want to do any roleplay before that, feel free.
Can I talk to the... I keep wanting to say royalness. Fucking...
Your royalness?
the family themselves.
Sylvanas, an elven man with beautiful salt and peppered hair that seems to fall back. It's not very long, it's about medium length hair. He seems to have this goatee on his face with a chin strap beard starting to come in. He's a bit paler than the rest of the elves you've seen before. He stands about 6'7". He's a bit more burly for an elf, and he seems to wear these black and red regal attires. Is seemingly talking to Klara. Eventually he comes and talks to you as you do ask for him from a few of the maids. Hello there, little plant. What can I do for you?
Hello. Hi. Well, first of all, my name is Pumpkin, or Moss Fist, if you'd prefer. I can't do it high voice today. I kind of just wanted to see if you knew anything about this city, counting you live here, and I'm kind of new.
Okay. You obviously see, as you're talking, he's like, yes, and he's staring at Klara. But he goes, the city, what is it you wish to know about it?
I heard about someone named Celsius? Celsius?
Do you mean Celis?
Yeah, Celis. Thank you.
Celsius with his brother.
You just completely fucking made me forget the name of the deity I made. Celis. You mean Celis.
Celis. Yeah, Celis. Yeah, Celis.
She is a very powerful... Well, she's the patron god of Tirok. Why?
Patron god?
Yes, she is the moon goddess, the one who brings life to... I'm not really that religious towards her specifically, but I do know some of her doctrine. It's stated that during the first age, she aided the world, she helped create the world to an extent, creating lesser deities to aid her. In doing so, she created the other two moons. She's the moon goddess, basically.
Is she physical? Or is she kind of dead?
She does not show herself to us. Why would she? She is a god.
Jesus showed himself.
Well, no, just... Oh, nothing. Just old past life memories is all. Anyway, well, I'm gonna be honest with you, I somewhat forgot what I was gonna say, but either way, thank you for having us, and this, I hope tomorrow night will go well.
Before you go, how long have you known this Klara individual for?
A good bit. A good bit.
What is her deal, should I say?
If I were being honest with you, sir, I would not trust her. She is off. No one knows what's exactly wrong with her. She's just not right.
Okay. Pangolin, Klara, roll me opposed diplomacy checks in chat, please.
Diplomacy? I'll take a plus 9 to diplomacy.
I'll take a plus 13.
Eh, well, rolls are rolls.
Natural 1 for both of you.
15. What's a 2?
Ooh.
Ball on the field. Okay, so roll more than... Yeah, okay, so I will do 20
plus.
Roll
more than a 6.
Not 1.
I rolled a 4. Ooh, damn.
I will say, I'm gonna let you roll again, just because she is a Draconoid, and you are saying, be careful of this person who just appeared before you.
Man, fuck you.
Okay,
oh, fuck you.
Thank you for your concern, and he's looking over at Klara. Klara? You know what? Because I'm being a dick, I'll say this is going to be 3 checks for both of you, so Johnny, go ahead and roll 3rd one, and Klara, roll 2 more. Just to make it more fair here. Because you both rolled so fucking low.
Hold on, let me finish mine out so we don't get, like, different shit. Okay. Okay. Two,
so it's
2
win for him, and then we're going to see if he gets higher. And then 2 wins for Klara.
What are you?
I'm sorry, he goes...
Oh, 27
Thank you for the warning, but honestly, I do not see anything wrong with her. In
just
fact, I see
keep
a lot
worrying.
Right with her. Anyway,
just keep worrying.
I'm not right with her. Hey, yo.
Thank you, my plant friend. I saw you arranging the garden. Beautiful display. Thank you. Anyway,
you're welcome. Thank you.
Do you drink wine?
Occasionally, yeah. For big events.
Clap your hands together. Jeeves! And you see this, this very elongated, gray-skinned elven individual, only wearing a loincloth, come walking in like Gollum from Lord of the Rings. Yes! Bring this one of our finest wines. Oh, and, bring me the best wine we have, too. And he goes... Yes, sir! And he starts to fucking jingle away like a jester. Walking. Eventually, a bit of wine is brought to you, Pangolin, and some is brought to him. Well, is there anything else you would like to speak about?
Oh, yes, there was... That, I heard rumors about someone falling into the rivers. Do you know anything about that? It was one of
the
rivers it was one of the students of the mage school.
Oh, sorry, I have an ad playing on Spotify. I'm just gonna go ahead and stop that. go to a different one.
Oh, so you killed a child.
No.
Yeah, no.
Because it's so big. If you okay, I'm just gonna mute it until it's done playing the ad, to be honest with you.
Wow.
Anyway, so he goes, many people fall into the rivers, even students. Why do you ask?
Oh, well, there was something about her doing something of interest. Like,
did you catch the name of this student?
Fuck, what was the name?
I don't know. Do you remember it?
I might. Can I roll for it? My memory's hot garbage. Check. My memory's hot garbage today.
Roll me an intelligence check.
R1D 20 plus 1.
Man's got the gut dang.
16.
It's Tatriel.
Tatriel. Her name was Tatriel.
Suddenly have a look of recognition. He goes, I do not know anything about her falling into the rivers in Lego City.
A man has fallen into the Lego River and the Lego City with Legos.
I'll look into it, but thank you for bringing this up to me.
No problem. Take it easy. I will form for you later. And thank you for the wine, by the way.
Big shot. Contested roll with me, please. Just roll a diplomacy check, please.
I'm scared.
Uh-huh.
Against his will save here.
No.
Oh god. Oh no. Any kind of bonus?
Yeah, it's your diplomacy, fuck ass.
You know what I meant?
No.
Ooh.
Yeah. Yikes. So, just for the audience, as this man has a little hint of recognition in his eyes, and you see the pangolin walk away, holding this wine, he thinks about approaching Klara for a second, turns away and goes, why would Tatriel fall into the river? I need to speak with Ellerin. And he starts to walk away very fast. Everyone in the room sees him just walk out of the room out of haste.
It's pitch and damn.
No. Anyways, let me just say, Johnny Shitknuckles, you may have just saved the other party from a TPK.
Hey.
With that little piece of information, I fuck you not. That is the only thing that is going to save them from probably dying. So, thank you. Hell yeah,
you're welcome. Fuck yeah. Make sure you mention that. I will.
Anyways, because there was something happening with Tatriel, and she was kind of afraid, and didn't want to go. Didn't want to go talk to the Thunder Branches. That would have been fucking shitty. But anyway.
So I just saved them. That was fucking dumb. Curious.
Yes.
And ran out of things to say.
Out of character. Yes.
I ran out of things to say. I'm like, oh, fucking Tatriel. Sure.
Leaves the room. Patrick, Osha, what are you doing for the last 2 hours in the game?
Trying to sober up fucking Lillian.
Alright, Lillian is unconscious because she fell down some stairs. But she does awaken after an hour, and as you like come back into the room after like cleaning yourself off a little bit, you see her like reaching over. You see a maid in the room pouring her some more alcohol as Lillian goes,
No.
Thank you. And she starts to go to drink some wine.
No! Lillian, stop!
Give her coffee.
Do you smack it out of her hand? Do you smack it out of her hand?
Very much so. No.
God, she rolled a natural one for her con save, just so you're aware. Or a fortitude save, sorry. So, she's still drunk. And you smack it out of her hand, she goes, no fun. You should drink some too, Osha. It's good.
You forced me to get several different sets of clothing today. The amount of anger in my system.
He falls asleep.
Damn. Hitler really killed himself 10 days after his birthday.
Okay. That's what happens when you turn 30.
It's fine. I'm gonna cock her mouth back.
and pour in one of my health potion things, because they give a bonus to get, try to get a mute, try to get poisons out. It's a plus one bonus, by the way.
Okay, so yeah, no, I was just rolling a percentage against a percentage to see. So you can see the obvious look of like strain on her forehead from like thinking because of her hangover is starting to lessen a bit. She'll probably be not hungover once she awakens.
Ah, great. Oh, fucking god damn it.
Patrick.
Yeah.
What are you doing?
Patrick is pacing back and forth and trying to think of, or well, he's repeating jokes and shit, because if you recall, he doesn't have his gun or the bottles, so he can't do his
thing. Oh, yeah! Oh, God. Okay. So go ahead and just make me an intelligence check to see.
Intelligence. Oh, that's right. I forgot he actually has really good intelligence. Because he's a crafter. Okay. 23.
23? Damn, okay. You come up with some nice jokes that you think will please the crowd.
Yeah.
So, as night falls, and you guys are getting suited up in some tuxedos and other drabs, whatever fits your fancy for the performance, if there's any other roleplay you would like to perform before you go out on stage or before you go to the stage, feel free.
I'm gonna need to know the demographic of the crowd we're playing for.
Elven. And some human. mostly noblemen.
Like, white boy elven or like...
Actually, no, sorry. You are performing for the ThunderBranch family and some of the noblemen. Not at the ball just yet. You're going to perform the next night completely. This is just practice, basically.
So they're okay. Mainly white, right?
Mainly white-based elves, yes.
Baller. So Sweet Caroline's definitely the move.
I'm going to talk to the rest of the party before we go up on stage.
Yeah.
Okay.
Miss Piggy.
Okay. So, here's the complete idea. Me and my good buddy, Patrick, here, had this idea a while ago. So, here's how I'm going. Shut the fuck up, harmonica player. You're a terrible bard. This is like a really depressed harmonica player now.
You just see OSHA talking to him.
You
better play that Minecraft Eat sound right now, piece of shit.
So, basically, a part of our act is gonna be a comedy show where we just shit on humans. So just like...
Oh, no.
Just like, we gotta make fun of them as much as possible.
Oh no.
What? Stop saying oh no. What's wrong?
We're gonna shit on humans.
No, not literally shit. We're going to like make fun of humans.
Your host.
The host is fucking human?
No.
Oh, he's not? What is he?
He's an elf, like most of the people in the fucking realm.
Okay, good. Okay. Holy shit, don't scare me like that. No, I'm nuts.
Listen.
All right.
One and five.
Got.
Four.
Tell them to drink every time I'm stupid.
Two. One. As
we're doomed.
On stage. So, this is your practice, and as you get pushed out, as you all are getting a little bit nervous, I want you all to make will saves. Well, technically, yeah, will saves here for me.
Oh, will save? Oh, fucking no problem.
27. Ugh.
Damn. No problem.
Oh wait, my will saves are
terrible. What's your little bushy boy?
27.
Give me a second. Podrick is good at most.
My 27. My will's amazing.
Welcome to the 27
28.
Club.
20 plus 8.
Let's fucking go.
So as you guys step out, Podrick, as the performance is going to continue, it's a practice performance, so hopefully you get your nerves out by the actual one. As Podrick goes up to start telling jokes, he starts to stutter a little bit and starts to look out. The entire crowd here is like a few noble people here who got here earlier just to like watch to see how it should go, basically. You see this elven individual with flowing blonde hair is just watching from the back. And you see Sylvanas, who's watching with a piece of liquor, talking to him as they both seem to be ignoring. You also see Lillian in the crowd at one of the tables, drinking heavily and going, "Woo!"
God, no! Fuck!
Time for Sweet Caroline.
Sweet Caroline.
You succeeded the fortitude saving throw finally. Okay. All of you,
help you.
Roll me performance you, checks. Except for Patrick, you're going to roll it with disadvantage here.
I hope you know that I have a
Get any kind of bonus for the nat 20 on my will save?
Sorry. Patrick, you're going to roll it with a negative 2. Bussy Boy, you're going to roll it with a positive 2. But Bussy Boy, what are you doing? You got to tell
what
me.
What am I rolling? Just normal fortitude?
Give me a fucking second. Bussy Boy, what are you doing?
I'm playing Sweet Caroline.
Bussy Boy, roll me a performance check with a plus 2 extra. We're gonna roll. Guys, don't roll just yet. Okay. Is that plus... Do you have plus 15 technically then?
What are you talking about?
Your performance. What is it?
I have a plus 11.
Okay. So, 24. That's fine. Johnny Shitknuckles, roll me a performance check.
10. Yeah.
Okay. What were you doing, by the way?
I was going to play the, if there was a piano, I was going to try and play the Interstellar soundtrack.
Okay.
Wow, you're going to play Interstellar while I'm playing Sweet Caroline? Fuck you.
Hey, Drake, what are you trying to do? Tell jokes, right?
He'll tell jokes and also he'll shit on humans a little and he'll fuck around with his...
Okay, I will...
face and his arms.
Are we gonna go through with the one plan?
Pedro, go ahead and roll me a performance check with a minus 2 penalty because you have nerves.
Dude, I already rolled one. Do you want me to roll it again?
Yeah, roll it again, please.
Did you say this thing, Patrick, that we mentioned?
The thing that we mentioned?
Yes, where humans. Oh. Every time a human's stupid, drink.
Yeah.
You're already fucking drunk.
It's funny, because he's a human, but I don't know if anyone can tell that. Because his...
Roll.
Yeah, okay. His face is really fucked up. So I
just want to make sure. Fuck! No! God!
I have the entire fucking sitcom soundtrack.
You guys hear Patrick stuttering a bunch, and like he's trying to do funny jokes, but the audience is just deadpan, like light-skinned staring at him. Zeus.
Yes.
What are you trying to do?
Okay.
Practice. Just to let you know, this will, depending on these rolls, help or go against your actual roll for the performance.
So if we roll low now, it'll be like a comeback, like an underdog thing.
You'll have
no, that works. No, that works.
Oh. So I'm definitely doing some sort of comedy routine. Combined with, I have those alchemical sparklers you talked about. I talked about with you. Okay. So, like, yeah, you get me. I think.
Maybe.
Want me to roll in channel or with?
In channel,
please. Okay. Yeah, I just want to double check before I was an idiot. Slash roll, 1d20. All right. I have a plus 9 to this.
Okay, roll.
Ah, 11.
11. You guys let it down. You guys let it down. Oh gosh, only Bussy Boy did good. So, as Clara's up there.
Hey, I'm a gambler, not a fucking comedian.
Yeah, so as Clara's up there singing Sweet Caroline, you guys are doing this performance, it seems.
Bad.
Bad.
I can boo.
You guys get a few boo. This is the best you've got, Sylvanas. This is the best you've got, Sylvanas. Trust me, this is just practice. They'll get better. And he stares at you guys, deadpan, light skin staring you.
That was Max.
You guys swear in your sin.
They just go from deadpan.
Sin City was amazing.
They all yell bomb 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 when the fucking Sweet Caroline plays, and then just immediately go back to the fucking deadpan.
Yes.
Sweet Caroline.
Bomb bomb bomb.
That's what it sounded like with Zeus in the carriage. But anyways,
God damn you.
So, as you all walk off stage, and this elven individual with beautiful chiseled face, more pointed to an extent, he looks very elven. He has these long ears that just completely point backwards rather than going out a little bit. He has this beautiful blonde hair that's unkempt, and it seems to fall down to his lower back. He goes, "Well," he has this very beautiful suit that's just made for him, it looks like, in these fingerless kind of gloves. He goes, "Well, that was, disappointing.
Bad.
To say the least.
Don't.
Bad. Bad.
Don't say anything.
Bad.
I am the one who hired you, so I will say something.
Bad. It was bad.
I ran into an unfortunate incident, and, I don't have my gun, so..."
"Oh, you need a gun. I can get one for you immediately."
"Perfect. You know what? I got a plan for the second act.
I really hope you do better, because simply put, you're going to be forming in front of one of the royal children of the king, just so you are aware."
Get the guillotine ready.
That's not
normal.
What's your relation to this person?
We're friends.
Oh, friends, okay. No shit talking.
Yes. Anyways. You don't do better, you don't get paid. That's the whole point.
Or we die.
I could probably get you off the hook as long as you don't shit talk them. Or don't
completely understood.
Or don't completely bungle the bag.
We're all having fun here. Let's not put death on the table.
Oh no!
That's always on the table.
Gringle,
are you not having fun?
Gringle. I cannot guarantee much.
My name is not Gringle.
Not you, Zeus. What fucking character are you playing this time?
OSHA! The fuck is Gringle?
Which one of you is Gringle?
The fucking Shadow.
The fuck is Gringle?
I cannot guarantee
my bag. I'm gonna be sorry.
That is the worst nickname I have ever given in my entire life.
My next character is going to be named Gringle the Clown, bro. I swear to you.
Gringle
the Clown. He was born out of metaphor ideas.
My name is Elrin, since you all seem to be laughing about this Gringle character I've yet to be introduced to. I'll get you your gun. Do you need anything else, Sir Patrick?
Bunch of empty bottles or something I could shoot at.
There would be a few of those, but also you look very horrifying, I must state.
May I ask for something?
Also lost my mask.
Yes, plant person.
I need a harp. Is that
arrangeable? Yes.
Thank you.
And anybody else need anything besides a jester mask, a gun, bottles, a harp? This is starting to sound like that strange...
A will to live?
That strange new warehouse that's opened up that ships random things. I think it's called Zamazon?
I need...
Do you have a will to live in the back?
I thought it was called...
I believe a getaway vehicle would be a good idea.
No.
Shit. It's worth a try.
You guys realize how fucked we are, right?
And you, Clara.
I'm fine. Y'all aren't.
Clara.
I need...
What you're talking about?
I need an outfit. I need...
Guns.
An outfit.
Golden spot, that's correct?
Yep.
I've got you. My father took a picture, apparently. So I'll send it to you. I'll, get something similar.
Don't forget, we're still on for dinner.
That is not me. That is my father.
I meant your father.
You cannot seduce me, Draconoid.
Sure as hell can try.
My father may want to get in your lair, but I do not.
Ugh.
Apparently you didn't hear me call him son.
Wait, you call me son? When do you... I hate you. Anyways, I will be going. If you need anything, contact one of my many men. I'm Elrond. Goodbye. And he walks away.
Alright.
You see a few of the noble ladies come up to him, and he's like, "Ladies, ladies, please. I have only so many arms." As he continues to walk.
All right, fuck faces. I got some shit to take care of. Get your act together. I'm gonna walk off to Lillian.
Fuck, I dropped my Fritos. My Fritos lay on the ground. Yo. Rest of the group, what are you doing?
I, once I get the harp, will be practicing best I can.
Yeah. Patrick, what are you doing?
When he gets his gun, he'll be practicing, doing, like, he doesn't need to actually have anything to shoot right now. He just needs to practice, like,
gun, by the way.
That's okay. He just needs to practice his flourishes and shit right now.
You could tell that it's not elven made because it's long and, like, very skinny in certain parts. Well, sorry, not human made. It's probably made by the elves here.
All bro needs to do is shoot his gun when I play.
What's and different about it is the barrel is made of mithril, not gun steel. So
it's really light.
Yeah, very fucking light. And it has a mahogany finish to the wooden parts. It's a very ornate looking one, basically. So, as you all practice, Osha. You approach Lillian and she goes, Osha, I can't remember anything that happened within the last day, so I apologize if I was drunkenly stammering or something. Also, what is this strange outfit you've got me in? Osha, hello?
Yeah. Oh, sorry.
So?
Oh. So what? Another place. I'm very stressed out of my mind.
Well, I was going to apologize because I can't remember anything that happened. So whatever happened, apologies. And
oh,
I asked,
yeah,
what the fuck this dress is? I haven't worn something like this since I got out of the tribe I belong to.
Alright. Long story short. You kind of lost everything within yourself onto your dress. And I had to very quickly make you not naked.
Oh, thank you for that.
We need to steal a dress for you and or buy one.
Well, this is a pretty nice dress. After all, we don't have to do anything until tomorrow. So, oh. Also, your performance was abhorrent.
Yeah, I know.
And what's bad is you're not getting any practice tonight. Anyways, so.
What?
So, as she says this and the rest of the party practices, what are you guys doing for the next day? Osha, by the way, you get fucking fucked for the rest of the night. Roll me a performance check.
God, I have so little time.
She doesn't care.
She's 21.
Again, completely dominating her because you rolled fucking shitty.
Hey, yo!
You are gonna have some powerful children, just by the way.
That's great. I don't need magic.
Anyway, so. The rest of the group, what are you doing for the rest of the day? Because Osha's kind of missing for the entire day.
I am going to be tuning my instrument.
Same here, just practicing.
Get this sumbitch perfectly in tune.
I'm fucking.
So.
It'll work. It'll be great.
As your group prepares to go on stage, Osha coming in looking very drained, looking like you're getting too much sleep, starts to approach. You guys see Klara is wearing currently at the moment this, what is it called? It's a trench coat. Obviously wearing makeup on her face and everything. You see the plant individual has a harp in his hand, and Patrick has a jester mask on. That is what you guys look like.
We're fucked.
No, I'll be fine. You are fucked.
I might be okay.
I need to... Alright. I got my plan. We can. Yeah.
Well, I have a plan.
You all certainly fit the bill. You guys see walking up to you is this halfling who's wearing these cowboy boots and seems like a foot taller than other halflings. He goes, after all, you do look like ragtags, and you seem to act like them. Name's Remington Remington, leader of the ragtags. Nice to meet you. I didn't know we were hiring individuals such as yourself.
Ah, OSHA Burns. I hold my hand out.
He holds his hand out and takes it. Nice to meet you. So, go on stage, do not embarrass us, and we will pay you and make you honorary members, of course. Because we don't want this getting out that you used our identity.
Please save me.
We'll pay you each We'll pay you each 5 gold if you give a good performance. Otherwise, you do not get paid.
I think we're about to ruin your reputation.
Oh. Trust me, if you ruin our reputation, I will out you.
Oh, we'd have to kill you.
listen. Sir, if you can't do much to us if we ruin this, Ken will probably be dead. So.
Damn if you do, damn if you don't. Let's,
send help. Please.
I'll be fine.
I don't want to be here.
Diplomacy check, Johnny.
Roman's begging for your life check.
Send help. I do not want to be here. Not my idea. 20. When my diplomacy is +9. Yeah, +9. Yeah, +0. How lovely. Dirty 20.
I can send a few acrobats to aid with some of your. Who here is doing more practical, like, hands-on based things? I know Patrick over here, I believe your name was, is doing something with firearms and bottles. We can add an acrobat there to improve your designs.
All I'm doing is a harp.
Well, we can't help you there, because we don't really have any musical people here.
Scared.
And the ones we do kind of lost their fucking fingers in the frost the other night.
I'm making
well, it looks
explosions.
Like it looks like you're in line to need a new musician. This is where I come in. Hi, my name is Klara. I'm gonna reach out.
Do not trust them. She is batshit crazy and not in a good way.
You're a musician.
Yes.
No, she's not.
After the show, if you survive. And I believe the two humans here are performing more practical things, such as explosions and firearms, correct?
Yeah.
We can give you both a few acrobats to help you, however, you will only be paid 3 gold for success then.
That works perfectly fine.
Excellent.
Do they have insurance?
Why'd you have to say yes?
Okay. Good talk.
Anyways. You're on in a few minutes. I believe Clara will be the first one up, if anybody wants to go out with her. I believe you said that you were going to go out with this plant individual, but I don't remember.
I do not think firearms and a harp go well
Clara
together.
I said Clara and a harp. So the singer and a harp. Hear that? Oh, I have another ad I have to skip here. Blah, 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 blah.
By the way, I can play some actual harp music gently.
You do not have a motherfucking harp in your room.
Well then,
no, I have a soundboard.
Clara, if you would like to give us the beginning of the show, the breaking entrance, the icebreaker, as they call it.
All right, Clara, we'll do like this. You sing your song, but like softer, to match with the harp.
Listen, I just want Gunman there. Give me some nice beat.
Okay, Clark, you go first. And he just pushes you out onto the stage.
Beyond.
We'll go in order, I guess, because none of you fucking prepared yourselves for this. Clara, what are you doing for your performance?
I am going to be performing music. I don't think I want to do Sweet Caroline again.
I believe you're going
do some
to
Aerosmith.
Rip your trench coat off to reveal your outfit, correct?
Aerosmith.
You know what? I got the outfit. I know exactly what song I'm gonna play.
Money, my bet.
Nope. See bet.
Oh no.
What? Would they enjoy that, Schmuck?
I don't know what the song is.
It's the beep.
But here.
It's the sex song.
Oh. Why did you do brown 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 instead of what the fuck was beep there? Yeah, do brown 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 brown, not fucking beep beep beep, beep fucker.
25 seconds.
You know,
make
what,
a reference correctly.
You know, I'm gonna do Careless Whisper.
That works with a harp. Good.
Well, no. Good. They're not going out together. Fuck.
Oh, they're not. Oh, they're not. Because he got shoved out. Because we're stupid.
Careless Whisper plus stripping. Amen.
that works. Strip.
So, as you strip. Know, would you like to describe the design of your outfit, please?
No, I'd rather let you do that.
Okay.
Oh God, you know
it's
what?
Massive tits. Huge bazongers.
You see, you see this brownish red kind of kobold go out, and as they strip off their trench coat and begin to sing, you see these large bazingahas hanging out in front of them, completely bare, besides with these golden speckled, like, what is it called? Glitter all over their tits. You see, as they're out there, their horns, curl forward a bit, and they have these caps on the end of it that come off with these tassels, as well as some tassels hanging from their tits as well.
Schmuck, I'm just gonna do a picture.
Okay.
Of what I
send me it as well.
Fine.
Big Shot, are you wearing a grass skirt or are you not wearing anything like that?
I'm gonna send it to you.
Okay.
Oh my God.
Okay.
Sounds like Bob approves.
You gotta paint the image here.
Okay. No.
You know what? Should I just send it in chat?
No. Never mind what I said. You see her come out with this golden collar on, with many golden
beads. Put in naughty things.
Pieces of jewelry.
Delete that.
I'll just fucking stop then, I guess. Never mind. You come out with a sexy outfit. So go ahead and roll me a performance check.
The sexy outfit. Very well. Do I get any bonus from the pre-gaming?
No. Because you didn't let me talk.
Ah, get fucked. Don't get fucked.
They wouldn't let you talk. I was letting you talk. Don't punish me for their mistakes. Come on.
Roll me a diplomacy check to see if people like your outfit.
Okay.
DC is pretty high.
Damn you.
Roll me the big dick check.
They're elves. They're racist. Remember.
Roll me a D20. Ah, she got that 20-inch deep pussy. I see.
Good God!
Fucking deepish over here.
Yeah, they call me the New York pizza.
That's over.
Fucking Boeing 747 over here, fuck's sake. Grand Canyon ass bitch.
Bitches always be asking where the cheese at.
Not one.
So Schmuck, just out of curiosity.
Yeah?
Is there any way I can change this?
Do you have a hero point?
I do believe I do.
Hero point on the stripping.
I do have one left, yes. I'm gonna mark that.
Be a hero, strip better.
If you want to, yeah. I was gonna go with the disaster on your outfit falling apart on you and being completely naked, but I guess not.
That wouldn't be a disaster to some people's eyes.
I know, that's what I was gonna say.
27.
That's good. That's a fun number.
Instead of trying to, like, shift it over to be like, oh, this is meant to be a costume design failure, that's why I'm completely naked. You want to get a +1 instead.
They whoop it. I have an additional +1 to...
Yes.
Sweet.
And I'll say, because you have gotten a performance good, you get a +2 extra because you didn't fail last time, you got pretty good.
So that's a +3 then.
No, +2.
Cringe.
So you have +15 to this performance. Well, no, you have +13 to this.
13, yeah.
Yeah.
All right, here we go. 26.
26.
Right. The dance in the crowd goes, woo! Sexy ass looking kobold here! And you hear,
boobies!
Fucking kobolds. What the?
Titties!
She's got some talent, but I mean, she's still a fucking kobold. You hear, shut the fuck up! Hold up, somebody pull up the Dr. Phil. Shut the fuck up.
Shut the fuck up.
Please do it. Yeah.
I hate you, I'm gonna kill you, I want $300, shut the fuck up.
Shut up, bitch.
Shut up, bitch. Fucking The Rock. Shut up, bitch.
Says anything about empowering women.
Shut up, bitch.
So, as the bussy girl enters backstage, there's a few individuals that are cheering for her as she goes back in. You see Ramtem go, nice, nice. Now, if we continue with that, I think you guys will have earned your keep. Next,
I'll go last so we can finish out on a chill note.
Next, we're going to add in a little bit of a strange thing. We're going to add in one of the practicals next. We're going to add in you, Osha.
Ah, okay.
So, actually, hold up. No, because you're using explosions. No, we're going to go with something else here. Aside from my better judgment, Phaedric, you're next. Get ready to shoot stuff while someone juggles.
Aside from my better judgment.
Do they mind if I try to shoot whatever they're juggling?
Phaedric, yes, favor. Face not toward the crowd, so you don't accidentally shoot the royals if you miss.
I know what I'm doing, alright? I'm the one who knows how to handle a gun.
I don't care. Please do not shoot the fucking royal.
Actually, I have to see which of the two royals.
Hey, well, here. I was about to say, well, I might have already.
Do not shoot the fucking royals.
That's exactly the idea.
Don't shoot another.
That's funny. That's actually, hold up, let me roll to see if I can convince. Yeah, no,
that's fine. Okay. So,
see if the one who I shot is here.
Oh, you shit. Walk out in this beautiful, go ahead and describe your outfit, please.
Alright, he's just still in this very deep forest green cloak that shines in the lights.
Well, you could have gotten changed into a different outfit. They were all three different outfits.
Oh, well, then he'd basically be wearing a... What is in his... I need to look at it so I can describe it, because my brain doesn't do good at describing stuff unless I look at it. Alright, so he's wearing these, like, gray pinstripe pants with black leather boots. And instead of the cloak, he now wears this leather, like, shotgun coat. With a silk blue interior, and the outside is brown leather. He wears a blue vest beneath to match the inside of the coat with a brass chain.
Okay. So as you go out and look at the crowd, do a little bow beforehand, you notice the royal you shot, as well as another individual that looks similar to them. You see the beautiful, pale-skinned, illustrious, let's see, what's her name again? Can't fucking remember the fucking names of my people here.
Roberta.
No. It's not Jim Gordon either.
Morgan Freeman.
No.
Jordy Greep.
Barry Allen.
No.
Tim
Flash Allen. Gordon.
Gordon Freeman.
You see, the middle daughter of the, No, that's not it. No, that's
G-Man.
That's Larinae. What the fuck am I doing here?
Charlotte.
The second princess of the royal family of Tyrellian, the 5'10 female elf, snow white skin, skinny yet curvy body, sporting scarlet red hair, unlike her
would.
Sister. She seems to be sitting there in this beautiful pink and lavender dress as she stands there drinking alcohol, sitting next to a man that looks very similar to her. You see this taller elven individual with the same scarlet red hair and these beautiful amber eyes, this pristine, like, if you weren't, like, completely straight, like, definitely would, this beautiful faced man, who seems to be wearing this blackened toga, and he just sits there, and you can, see them talking to each other as you walk out. By the way, his cheekbones are much more pronounced than hers. As they seem to be talking, you walk out. She looks over to you and just does a small little hand wave towards you. And the individual sees this next to her, looks over to you, and does the same hand wave to you, cocking his head to the left.
And he'll make like a sort of general greeting gesture, but he won't necessarily make it directly at them. He'll just sort of greet the crowd. After his bow.
I forgot to do nerves for Bussy Boy, but it doesn't matter. So, as you do so, and two other acrobats join you on stage, they do a bow as well, and you hear one of them go, "Are you sure about this? He's gonna be shoot." "Yes, I'm sure about it. No, shut the fuck up." And you hear, Alright, boys and girls, we're going to be juggling. This individual is going to be shooting it out of our hands. You know the whole drill. It's going to be fun. Watch. And they start to juggle.
Please.
Go ahead and
do not.
Roll me a will save.
Do not shoot the fucking royals.
I'm not gonna shoot the royals. I'm gonna shoot the jugglers
up,
if I shoot anyone.
If you fuck up and right, Mr. Shot, use a hero point.
Because of the fact that you failed the other one, I believe, with a natural one.
What
if the DC was... Oh, I have another ad playing.
Or wait, no. The natural one wasn't the...
Well,
the
I'm still
state.
Gonna say, because you got that natural one on the last thing, the DC was still pretty high because you also failed last one. The DC was 25, funny enough. So, you feel the nerves once again starting to bolster up as both of them wave at you. And you're like, okay. As you pull your pistol up, aiming, as one of them is juggling bottles, the other one's juggling apples, and they start to switch in between them. Actually, no, they're not switching in between at the moment. One of them is juggling bottles at the moment.
Oh, he's not pulling his pistol up. He's doing a quick draw to start.
Okay. So, as you look towards this, having your hand over your hip, what do you do?
Cry, pray.
He is going to try to take all three things one of the jugglers is juggling with like one quick draw first.
Okay. Go ahead and
just
make
one
me
of the...
just make me an attack roll.
Alright.
Do not.
And does
miss.
That have any what is the
you have a negative two extra bonus to it.
Okay. That's still not a bad attack bonus. 19.
He managed to shoot all three out of his hands. Eventually, you do get to the end of the performance. If you'd like to make me a performance check really quickly here. This will be for the first half of the performance of you shooting things out of single people's hands.
18.
18. So as the performance continues, you do manage to please the crowd a little bit, and you hear, oh, what's this? And you see the two jugglers go. Alright, this is the last bit here. And they come up to you as they're talking. Now we're going to be making this infinity-like symbol, and we're going to be switching hands as we juggle towards each other to an extent. You're going to have to shoot all of the items out of our hands, okay?
Can do.
And they look at you. You aren't nervous, are you?
Nah.
Alright.
Shaking, nah.
And they start to
do
go
this
over.
For a living.
It's to be the last of our juggling performance. Please watch as we do the infinite shot. And they both start to get into positions. One of them starts juggling, the other one starts, and they start to throw it to each other, catching it, adding it into their juggling. And you hear, all right, we're ready. Whenever you're ready. Patrick, as you look out to the crowd one more time, reloading your gun, the princess looks over to you once more, winks, and blows a kiss towards you. And the prince, seeing this, mimics it on the other hand, doing the same thing. Roll me a will save, please.
Okay.
He's... Oh no, he's hot!
Is this,
He thought hands were Squidward, basically.
Oh no, he's hot!
Is this have any... Does this have a minus two to it because of already nervous?
Yeah.
Okay. Nine.
Ooh, no!
That's a critical failure, so...
Ooh!
Okay. So, your hands begin to shake a little bit more as you get ready to shoot them.
God damn it.
We're fucked. We are fucked.
Go ahead and make me an attack roll with a minus -7 total and a disadvantage.
We're fucked.
Holy shit, Mickey Mouse's voice actor is black.
You better use a fucking hero point.
You see his hand as he goes ready to get his gun. His hand is obviously like
fucking shaking.
Yeah, you can hear the metal. Basically the Gmod ragdoll in the door.
Oh wait.
No, it's more like
what is it? Is it just DIS for disadvantage?
Space DIS, yes.
Yeah, okay.
That's out of everything that could just happen, not bad.
Pulling it. You wait. Fire! Six shots.
Oh, it was also supposed to be a 19 because I put a 3 instead of a 4.
You had a -7 in total, remember?
Yeah, he has a plus 11 to hit.
Okay.
Just take the victory, be happy.
You hit every item, now let's see. Yeah, okay. You hit every item out of their hands, and you see them both cower a little bit afterwards, looking at you as your hands, like, obviously shaking with the gun in it. And you hear the audience go quiet for a second. Woo! Oh. Roll me a performance check, please. Actually, no, sorry, they go quiet, now roll me a performance check, see how well
they do. That a minus 7?
Yeah.
Okay.
No disadvantage, that, though.
That one is a plus 3. Oh.
Woo! A few people wooing.
Oh, I didn't kill anyone.
More people are kind of scared of the fact that you, like, it's more, how do I say this, your performance check. So, as the crowd starts to cheer a little bit, you go and turn around and bow, and your mask hits the ground, and everyone goes, what the fuck? Who is the... You need to leave!
You need to leave.
Like, people start throwing bottles at you and shit to get off stage.
He'll bow while they're throwing shit at them. At him, I mean.
Okay.
Shit.
And while he's bowing, he'll pick
Hold
up
Hold on, y'all.
Mask.
I hear children screaming.
Next Let him die. Him. It's fine.
Just put some soundproofing in your basement, man.
Oh.
Okay, I'm thinking, what if I went on stage and
socked
him? I think
they busted out the basement. Damn it.
What'd you say?
Hold on, I'll be right back.
What'd you say, Osho?
I'm thinking. I was thinking out loud.
Yo. Tadric, do you leave the stage?
While he's bowing, he picks up his mask and puts it back on so that when he stands up, it's back on, and then he's, thank you, you've all been very kind.
A bottle hits you square in the fucking forehead, roll me. Actually, no, this is gonna be an attack roll. This bottle shatters all over you as you're covered in this liquid now.
Ah, appreciate it.
By the way, I will say this, Pedrick, you noticed this. Lillian is sitting with the two individuals that you know, the prince and princess.
Oh.
Oh no!
The prince is looking at you like disgusted, and the princess is just looking at you, licking her lips a little bit.
She's.
I think that's worse. I think that's worse than being disgusted.
Horny, horny.
Well, she's already experienced.
Yeah,
Pedro's the goop man.
It's significantly longer than that.
Yeah, I know.
Even.
My point stands.
He already put a few feet in her, you know?
Yeah.
Anyways.
My point stands. Horny, horny.
As you walk off stage back to the back, everyone just sees Patrick is covered in multiple liquids and different things, like tomatoes and whatnot. Just let you know.
I think I did good.
That's one in one.
Now it's up to me.
Well, hey. Osho.
Yes.
Actually, no, Osho will be the finisher because he has the explosions to end it off.
Alright. This is supposed to be a nice pacer in between.
Yeah. And coming out now, we have the great top player from deep within the forests, an unknown plant individual, calling themselves, what did you call yourself?
Pumpkin.
They call themselves Pumpkin of the Perfect Pitch, playing for us. The grand Tarakian theme of the crown. Please enter in, Pumpkin. And you hear a few people. Woo! You hear a few people. Who the fuck is Pumpkin?
What motherfucker named this thing Pumpkin?
God, motherfucker, damn.
Yeah, motherfucker, damn.
So
this stands for pumpkin in your ass.
Wait. Wait, pumping kin in your... Okay, I understand.
Stop it.
That was a good one. I'm going to high five myself. Fuck you guys.
Okay, you're going to have an extra hero point.
Yeah, holy! Actually, may save everything.
Didn't Patrick have a hero point he didn't use?
I have one I have not used yet.
I did not have a hero point. I checked because I wanted to reroll that performance check and I didn't have any.
Hold up, I have a knock on my door.
Knock back.
Hey, you know what? Podrick did fine in his performance. It was just unfortunate that everyone there was really mean and called him ugly.
Alright, so...
Hey, you're only ugly to everyone but, like, three people.
Hey guys,
feel better.
So, before Pumpkin manages to get on stage, just take, like, a 10-20 minute break.
Cool.
What you need to do. I'm gonna stop the recording right here and then pick it back up when we go again.